Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4, Part 90, and this segment we're going to do some fucking sciencing here. So, I have this Jaguar E-Type. This is not its stock form, because it has all the handling upgrades on it. Nope, no engine upgrades, just because I've been fucking around with the upgrade shop. So initially, I had upgraded this, went to the quick upgrade. This thing can only go all the way up to A-Class. And barely A class with a quick upgrade. This is with every upgrade part on it that isn't like aero. So, yeah, but I have a solution, and it's called an engine swap. So I'm gonna put the V8 XKR engine in this. No, I don't want to sell it. So, yeah, it's going to start off at less power than what I have, but it's also going to be lighter. And it's going to put me in S-Class, which is what I need, because we're finally graduated from A-Class and onwards to S-Class. I can also make this thing turbocharged if I twin-turbo, but I don't want to do that. So, let's upgrade this engine, shall we? I'm just going to go full race. Full race. This car is probably going to need this. This is going to be a fucking nightmare to control. Ooh, it's supercharged. Isn't that fancy? Oh, dear God. Alright, so here's our final spec. 708 horsepower, 576 pound-feet of torque, 2,300 pounds. In a very small car. Oh, God. I'm very tempted to put some aero on this thing. Just to have, like, downforce help me a little bit. But, I'll just keep it as is. So, let the science experiment commence. For it's time to go to the fifth column and the Jaguar Showcase and our first S-Class event of the event list. Can I be XJ220s with this thing? I don't fucking know. Probably not. This is probably going to be awful to control, because... Yeah, but let's find out with our first race at Silverstone International. Okay, here we go. I'm expecting all of the wheel spin, I'm just saying. Ooh, okay, second gear, no wheel spin. Now, how's this thing gonna turn? Because this is an old car. Even with the upgrades, it's still an old car, so it's not going to have the best handling. You know? This isn't that bad. I just have to drive it with some care because old car and also 700 plus horsepower. The race tires are really helping me because so much grip. And I'm actually keeping up and even out-accelerating the XJ220s. So, all hail the E-Type, the V8 E-Type. Holy shit. This is a good science experiment. And this is the fun part about being able to upgrade your cars. As much as I don't do it, it's just you can make such ridiculous things, like having a fucking old-ass E-Type beat an XJ220, you know? Slap a fucking V8 in it. Put a roll cage in it. Make that shit stiff as fuck. Put slicks on it. They don't stand a chance. This is fantastic. I love the fucking, like, look of the E-Type as well. It just has, like, the longest nose in the universe. And it's great. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh man. Alright. Losing a little bit of control there. We're good. We're good. Everything is fine. This does not sound like a fucking, like, anything what an E-type would remotely sound like if you looked at it. Yes, LS E-type. Clearly. This is the real V8 supercar, right here. Or the original. I don't know, shut up me. Ooh, forcing Rossi wide. Accidentally, because I forced myself wide. Plus that fucking supercharger, man. Fucking 708 horsepower into this tiny ass thing. I expected this thing to have like a be very ass happy. I'm not gonna lie, just by its shape, but obviously I was wrong. So Franken Jag is just gonna mosey on to victory here. Oh God. It's definitely not easy to drive. I have some care with it. But overall, this is great. Yeah, I expected this thing to just handle like a fucking just awful mess, but it's actually very well well behaved. God, the front is very sad. I may or may not have absolutely fucking destroyed the nose of this thing. So there we go. Oh shit. It's gonna be an interesting next three races. I might dominate them, but I don't give a fuck. Okay, I didn't give a fuck, but I don't give enough of a fuck to downgrade this thing. So, eh. And then there's the other people who don't matter, just way the fuck behind. So, oh, one down, three to go. Let's continue the Franken-Jag racing, yeah. Alright, so here we go. It is time for race two at Hockenheim. I don't remember which version of the circuit is. I think it's the short circuit. Might be the Grand Prix circuit. I don't fucking know. Point is, Franken Jag is on the fucking hunt. And the hunt is going well. I'm already up into P1. Alright. Hello and welcome to the show. Welcome to a new Motor Silly Carpool video, etc., etc. That's the National Circuit thing. It's not the full Grand Prix circuit. Alright. Original tack only goes up to 6,000. If only they knew what some idiot in a video game in 2017 would do to this thing, this poor thing. Well, Muller and Rossi are duking it out behind me for second. Door to door. And Muller into P2. Maybe he can catch the Franken Jag. Also, gotta stay classy with the wooden steering wheel. Yeah, by the way. Oh, fuck. Make the turns. Oh shit. Oh, say, can you fuck? By the Hockenheim's light? I don't fucking know. That didn't work. I'm not good at jokes. I'm sorry. Well, maybe if you didn't bitch about the ball, you wouldn't have gotten timed out. Bam, the end. Whoa. Oh, shit! Where we're going, we don't need roads. Also, Miller could not catch me. Ha 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 ha. Oh god. We're good. Everything's fine. We're okay. And there we go. Franken Jag takes race two. In dominating fashion. Although I just barely got the fastest lap. So it wasn't really that dominant, it's just I got into the lead immediately. So hooray. Alright. Hey, I'm now a Jaguar enthusiast, aka Affinity level 10. How about that shit? To race 3 we go. Alright, well, I should have won, but I fucked up. shit. Alright, let's drive again. Catalunya Grand Prix circuit. 2 laps. Franken Jag stops for no one. I remember when you cared about Forza 4 test drive, that sure was a good week. It was a magnificent week. Okay, so let's not, okay. Let's not die to death. I think I'm getting a little overconfident with the Franken Jag here. So we need to calm it down just a little bit here. It was like a month. You uploaded like, what, 10 parts? So 2 weeks maybe? Boy. Call me boy. Boy. Oh shit. Okay. I'm not driving this thing well now. So, heck. Hecky clecky. Ooh. What did I tell myself about the curbs? Fuck off with it. That shit. Alright, well, I got some ground to cover here. So, off we go. Stretch these 700 horses. And I did not gain as much on Miller and Rossi as I was hoping down front. Gonna have to kind of work hard for this win. So I did too much fucking about in lap one. So stop fucking about. Oh, okay. Cutting course. Track limits, bro. cheeky dive on more here. Actually was expecting it. See that? Just moved over a lane. Alright, let's go about this pass. It's basically how first attempt ended, except I'm going to do it better. Or not. Alright, let's get the run out of the turn. Come on, accelerate. Go, go, go. Ooh, oh, I got him. Barely got him. Whoa. Holy shit. 0.004. Margin of victory. Nice. Got him at the last couple milliseconds. Jesus. Well, there you go. Frank and Jag wins. And a photo finish. So now, let's go to the last race. Well, this finale is not going well. Yeah, Frank and Jag doesn't want to leave, so he's sabotaging my victory. Clearly. It's misbehaving. Okay. Like I said, misbehaving. So. Moving on. How's Forza today? A grand fucking adventure. Went from driving an SUV to fucking putting a V8 in an old Jaguar E-Type. Putting 700 fucking horsepower in this thing. So yeah, it's been an adventure. That was a bit lucky there. That didn't just go flying everywhere. Okay. Now. Let's go after this damn fucking win, shall we? Yeah, Frank Jag is now handling the way I expected it to handle. Just an insane piece of car. I think it's just I got overconfident with it, so I'm like, hey, I can drive this harder. Nope. Definitely not. At least I got around Miller cleanly. I don't know how the fuck I managed to do that, but eh. There we go. Now if I just do the same to Rossi, that'd be great. Because I think that was clean. Or more. I don't think I touched him. I don't even remember anymore. There we go. Nice and smooth. Diving. Don't mind me, Rossi. Alright, remember, decreasing radius on the exit. And there we go, P1, with one lap to go. Actually went very well. Nice calculated pass. Wasn't really what I was expecting, but hey. I shot my shot. Up succeeding. I just gotta keep him behind me throughout this lap. Okay. That was bad. That was very, very bad. Okay. Oh, alright. I was gonna say, now hit this early, swing out wide for the next apex, but I think I swung out a little too wide there. Just a little too wide. Not much, but you know. Let's keep it nice and tidy. Got one turn to go. That's a long one. Rossi trying to sneak up the inside on the exit. Can't do it. And there you go. Frank and Jag wins.
So, yeah,
that was overall a successful little science experiment. Hey, I got to show off the engine swaps, at least. And the fact that they exist in this game. And in Forza 3. And I think in Forza 2. I can't remember if ever in Forza 2. But there we go. That is the Jaguar showcase done. The first S-Class event on the event list. Complete, yay! So there were a hiccup, oh my god, there we go. So, yeah, let's hope I don't have to do anything as incredibly silly for the car I use in the next segment, but we'll find out next time. Stay tuned.